Now, RhinoGold 6.5 out of the box comes with access to the Elements Library. Now, this library is an online library of pre-made styles that you can select from and obviously go in and customize. So, not only can you select a style, but you can select sizes, metal colors, and later go in and change things like gem sizes and quantity of gems and all those sorts of things. So, if you click into one area, you see a preview of all the defaults for that category, in this case the signet ring styles. So you can click on one and go and customize that and place it in your document. And we've got categories like settings, and under settings we've got different styles. So just under halos, you can see that there are lots and lots of different styles which give you a great starting point for your designs. Same in the category clusters. So there's some existing styles of clusters which you can then go in and make changes to. So let's look at a three-stone ring or Trinity ring, and we'll pick maybe one of the basic styles here, something with a few gems on the shoulders here. Let's choose this. Now, when you select a style, it comes up and asks you for the reason, the region, I should say, which you can change, a ring size, which you can also change. So let's scroll down here and make this maybe size 10.5. You can select your base metal. You can change these once you've loaded a particular style, but this gives you a starting point. So let's choose yellow gold 18 karat. And again, you can choose your gem. So lots and lots of predefined styles, but again, I'll just stay with a diamond for the moment. And when you click on the validate button, it goes and sort of runs a macro. It basically goes and loads that design style and places it in your drawing at the correct ring size that we selected in the metal color that we selected. So if we look at this, say, from the top view, for me, I think these two smaller stones are a little bit too large in relation to the center stone. So let's place some smaller stones in here. So to do that, probably the easiest thing to do is just select one of the gems, and we can edit that gem and change a number of things, not only the cut of gem or the type of gemstone, but also its size. So we can select by carat weight or diameter and a whole bunch of other options. But I'll just drop this down to, say, a 3 mil stone for now. And you'll see when I place this, the bezel automatically resizes based on the new size of the gemstone. And I'm obviously going to need to move this closer to the central setting here. So it attaches there. So probably the easiest thing to do is just delete the one on this side. And I'll come to my front view and I can select the gem and the bezel and just sort of relocate it little by eye. Might want to rotate that a bit to match the angle there. Probably could be finessed a bit better than that, but that's okay for this exercise. So the next thing is, if you look, obviously our ring shank now is ending too far before the bezel, and also I don't like the starting position of these gems here that are on the shoulder. So we've got a lot of options within the shank tool. We can customize the width of the shank both in the end section, in the mid section, and in the base. We can change the shapes or cross sections that are used in each one of these sections as well. So to edit the shank, we simply click on it and click edit. And there are a lot of options in here which I won't go through just in this quick video, but we can actually set the start position or end position for the shank. So simply by dragging this little circular sphere here, I can actually move it up in closer to my bezel. And as I said before, the start position of the gemstones is not right, so I can shuffle that down a little further. So simply coming to the gems tab, I can decide whether I want gems on the shoulder or not. I can switch that off, of course, if I don't want any gems on the shoulder. Well, simply by flipping that switch, I can enable gems on the shoulder there, as you can see. So the thing I want to adjust is the start position, or what's called the gem's initial distance. So if I increase that, you'll see these gems starting to move down. You'll see some metal starting to appear here. So that sets the start position, and that's actually the distance from the end of the shank. So I'm happy with that. Now, of course, if I wanted more gems along the shank, you can do that here. You can adjust the size of the gemstones there. So it's a bunch of parameters that are controllable. For instance, adding more stones, you'll see that they add in the line down below the last gem, or I can remove them. So again, these are very simple controls. That looks okay, so I'll leave that. You can also adjust the cutter, or if you like, the channel that the gems sit in. So again, there are some controls for that. The initial distance, for instance, is that gap at the top. The end distance here, you can see that line moving. The depth of that cut, and also the gap or side margins, if you like. So I'm happy with that. I can go and adjust the prongs and all sorts of things here, but as I say, I'll just leave that as it is here. To adjust the prongs, if you wanted to, you could push them in closer or further apart, depending upon, you know, the width of the channel that they're sitting in. And if we're happy with that, we just click the check mark or the tick mark just to save that. So we just need to duplicate or copy this gem and bezel on the other side of our setting. So selecting the gem and the bezel, I can simply mirror them onto the other side. So now if I look in my top view, you know, that looks a lot better with smaller stones there on the side. And again, if I wanted to change the type of gems that are here, I can just select them and come into my materials library here and pick something else. So say I wanted them to be sapphires, I just double click on that and they're changed. And the same with the metal. I mean, let's say we wanted the setting to be in white gold. We come over here to metals and we've got a choice of default metals. So we can select all three of the settings and say change it to 18 karat white gold. And probably the last thing you want to do is just to round off the underside of the setting here of you know, the top section of the ring. If we look from our front view, you know, we want to round that off. And there's a tool to very, very quickly go in and do that. It's under our jewelry tab. It's called Adapt to Ring Size. And all we need to do is just tell it the components or the sections that we want to adapt for the finger, in this case, the settings. And you'll see it calculating, and it's now trimmed them off. And you can see they're nice and rounded, following the contour, or if you like, following the shape of the you know, the base of the ring. And that's it. It's just a very, very quick look at the elements library of components.